Because natural gas is currently the largest source of generation for electricity, natural gas prices have a lot to do with what you see on your electricity bill every month. What I hope to do in this video today is give you a better understanding of the six factors that affect natural gas prices and therefore your electricity prices. Hi, my name is Jim Mathers. I'm the president of Energy Professionals. On my channel, I discuss and review solutions that can help your business use less, waste less, and most importantly, pay less for your energy. When it comes to finding lower energy rates, we all have three points in common. Number one, we pay too much for energy. Number two, we all want lower rates. And number three, our energy bills are impacted greatly by the natural gas market. Here are six factors that affect natural gas pricing and therefore your electric bill. The first, weather. Now, weather is broken down into two factors. One, normal weather patterns. In the wintertime, we all know up north it gets really cold. When it gets really cold, a lot of people use natural gas to heat their homes and their businesses. When you use more of anything, it costs more. And in some parts of the United States, it's hard to get natural gas through little tiny pipes into big cities like Boston. So when the winter comes in the Northeast, natural gas prices skyrocket. It's just a matter of how much you're using and how cold it gets. The second part of weather is extreme weather conditions like blizzards, tornadoes, hurricanes, super freezing temperatures in states like Texas that freeze up and lock down all of the wind turbines. When these things happen, it causes a problem in the supply of natural gas or too much need for natural gas, and that causes the prices to skyrocket, even momentarily. The second major factor that affects natural gas prices is crude oil. Well, a lot of natural gas is a byproduct of oil rig drilling. So when there's fewer oil rigs in operation, there's less natural gas to put in the pipeline. If there's policy changes that all of a sudden there's no offshore drilling being done, pipeline maintenance is being disrupted, no more fracking is being allowed, all of these policy changes adversely affect how much natural gas is available to put in the pipeline. And again, supply and demand. If there's less natural gas, the prices are going to go up. Now, how do you know to predict whether your electricity prices are going to go up? Look at the gas pump. That's a direct reflection of oil prices. So, for example, we're gone from about $2 a gallon to over $3 a gallon in 1 year. Where do you think your electricity prices are going to go? That's right, up. The third factor is natural gas storage. Now, there exists in our country several places where we can store massive amounts of natural gas. It's expensive to maintain, but it keeps a steady supply of natural gas for when we have increasing and decreasing amounts of natural gas usage. In the wintertime, we really see the natural gas storage drop a lot. And in the wintertime, we see natural gas prices go up a lot. So natural gas storage has a big impact on your natural gas prices. The fourth factor is supply and demand. Now, a lot of this is common sense, but if you don't understand all the factors involved in natural gas production, storage, and ease of transportation, when you start affecting pipelines, like what recently happened when the gas pipeline was shut down, automatically there's a shortage. And when there's a shortage, there's an increase in pricing. Especially if the demand remains the same or even goes up and there's less supply, you're gonna see an instant increase in prices. For example, in the summertime, you may be in a state where it's really hot and you don't use natural gas except for to heat your home, but you use a lot of electricity. Understand, natural gas is being used to create most of the electricity that you use in your home or your business. And the fifth factor is economic growth. As our country grows in its supply and demand factors, including more manufacturing, more businesses, more people, more homes, you'll see an overall increase or demand for natural gas, both in terms of using natural gas for manufacturing processes. People don't realize some manufacturing plants that produce asphalt, for example, use millions of dollars of natural gas every year to create asphalt, which then goes on your roads. So there's a lot of natural gas use you don't even see day to day. And when you realize that every time your meter is clicking on your electricity, you are using natural gas to create 60% of electricity in your area, this creates more demand and therefore it's going to increase the price. Over the last 20 years, natural gas is higher today than it was 20 years ago. And this is largely impacted by the economic growth of our country. Inflation just exacerbates the economic growth. So if we're growing economically and we have an inflation, that means we need more natural gas, not less. And at this point, we're getting less natural gas available and the cost is going out the roof. And the sixth factor that affects the overall natural gas market is competition. So when manufacturers, pipelines, and other businesses are fighting over getting the best possible source for natural gas and the best price, this tends to keep the price of natural gas a little bit lower than it could be. So when there's more competition, it's actually better for you as the end user. You can check out one of my videos that we did on competition between suppliers who are looking to give you better pricing. So there you have it, the six major factors that affect natural gas pricing, which ultimately affect how much you see in your electric bill. At Energy Professionals, we have a commodity analyst on staff who keeps an eye on the energy markets, including natural gas and electricity, so we can give you timely updates on when it's the best time for you to renew your energy contracts. You can stay informed by energizing the subscribe button below. And also, look at our next video that will explain more about the deregulated energy markets. Have a great day.